We're going to start with a prayer. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear Father, we come into your presence.
Dragi Oče, dolazimo u tvoju prisutnost.
And we thank you for the gift of life.
Zahvaljujemo ti za dar života.
We thank you for the gift of the church.
Zahvaljujemo ti za dar crkve.
We thank you for the gift of this community.
Zahvaljujemo ti za dar ove zajednice.
And we praise you with the gift of the Holy Spirit.
I slavimo te za dar Duha Svetoga.
Please send the Holy Spirit upon us.
Molimo te, pošalji Duha Svetoga na nas.
To come and enlight our hearts.
Da prosvjetli naša srca.
And enlight our lives.
I da prosvjetli naše živote.
And enlight the church.
I da prosvjetli crkvu.
Through Christ our Lord.
Kroz Isusa Krista našega gospodina.
Amen.
Amen.
Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. So I'm very happy to meet you and to be here with you.
Jako sam radosna da vas upoznam i da budem tu s vama.
It is an honor for me always to share with the church and especially cloister.
Za mene je čast uvijek da dijelim sa crkvom, a pogotovo sa klauzurnim sestrama.
Because cloister nuns are a very strong hold of the battle.
Jer klauzurne sestre su jako snažna snaga borbe.
Because of you, we stop a lot of demons.
Radi vas zaustavljamo mnoge demone.
Demons that could get me.
Demone koje mogu mene.
So I thank you.
I zahvaljujem vam.
For stopping them.
Što zaustavljate.
I'm going to leave up to the Spirit whatever he wants to tell us.
Pustit ću Duhu što god nam želi reći.
The Spirit is always very punctual.
Duh je uvijek na vrijeme.
So, I'm going to start with a reading from Ephesians 5.
Počet ću sa čitanjem iz Efežanima 5.
Imitate God. As most beloved children of God, strive to imitate Him. Follow the way of love, the example of Christ who loved you. He gave himself up for us and became the offering and sacrificial victim whose fragrance rises to God. And since you are holy, there must not be among you even a hint of sexual immorality or greed or any kind of impurity. This should not be named among you. So too for scandalous words, nonsense and foolishness, which are not fitting, instead offer thanksgiving to God.
Budite dakle nasljedovatelji Božji, kao djeca ljubljena, i hodite u ljubavi kao što je i Krist ljubio vas i sebe predao za nas kao prinos i žrtvu Bogu na ugodan miris. A bludnost i svaka nečistoća ili pohlepa nek se i ne spominje među vama, kako dolikuje svetima. Ni prostota, ni ludorija, ni dvosmislenica, što se ne priliči, nego radije zahvaljivanje.
The word of the Lord.
Riječ gospodnja.
So, we are here together because God has chosen us.
Mi smo tu zajedno jer nas je Bog izabrao.
And we are His army.
Mi smo njegova vojska.
So we are his soldiers reunited to speak about our captain.
Mi smo vojnici koji smo sakupljeni da pričamo o našem vođi.
And about what is it that our captain wants from us.
I ono što naš vođa želi od nas.
In this particular battle we are in.
U ovoj sada bitci u kojoj se nalazimo.
Armies at war always have strategies.
Vojska u ratu uvijek ima strategiju.
And the captain of the army always sends instructions to the soldiers in the midst of the battle.
Kapetan u vojsci uvijek šalje instrukcije vojnicima u bitci.
So how does the battle looks right now?
Kako bitka izgleda sada?
Satan is really furious.
Satana je bijesan.
Because obviously he's always losing.
Jer uvijek gubi.
He's a loser.
On je gubitnik.
And but losers are dangerous.
Ali gubitnici su opasni.
Because losers are offended.
Jer gubitnici su uvrijeđeni.
So they are revengeful.
I oni su žele se osvetiti.
No compassion.
Nema nikakve suosjećanja.
And no forgiveness.
I nema nikakve oproštenja.
That is the nature of our enemy.
To je priroda našega našega protivnika.
We have to remember that because we are compassionate and we are forgiving.
Moramo se sjetiti pošto smo mi opraštajući i imamo suosjećanja.
Sometimes the enemy fools us.
Nekad nas protivnik zezne.
Because we lack sometimes discernment.
Jer nam nekad fali razlučivanje.
Because we expect everyone to be like us.
Jer mi očekujemo da svi budu kao mi.
And the devil knows that.
I đavo to zna.
So he plays with our compassion and forgiveness.
I on igra sa našom osjećajnosti i praštanjem.
But evil is unforgiving and uncompassionate.
A zlo je neopraštajuće i nesuosjećanje.
Demons are 100% evil.
Demoni su 100% zli.
So we have to fight them with 100% good.
I mi ih moramo se boriti protiv njih sa 100% dobra.
And we are imperfect.
A mi smo nesavršeni.
So we don't have 100%.
I mi nemamo 100%.
But the devil has 100% evil.
A đavo ima 100% zla.
So that's why Jesus comes along.
I zato Isus dolazi.
To complete us.
Da nas usavrši.
So for us to be 100%.
Da bi mi bili 100%.
We have to be 100% crucified with the Jesus.
Moramo biti 100% raspeti sa Isusom.
Our heart has to be on the cross.
Naše srce mora biti na križu.
We have to be free of any whining.
Moramo biti slobodni od bilo kakve
complain. It's like when you are crying for everything.
Bilo kakvog suprotstavljanja.
We have to be free of complaints.
Moramo biti slobodni od kako se kaže pritužbi, da.
Because to be free and to be 100% with Jesus.
Da bi bili slobodni 100% s Isusom.
We have to be 100% crucified.
Moramo biti 100% razapeti.
Which means it's not about me.
Znači nije, ne radi se o meni.
It's all about God.
Sve je o Bogu.
And it's all about salvation of souls.
I sve je o spasenju duša.
No matter how much the suffering is.
Neovisno koliko je trpljenje.
It doesn't matter.
Nema veze.
It's all for the cross.
Sve je za križ.
So I have to die to self.
Moram umrijeti sebi.
I cannot have not even a hint of me.
Ne smijem imati ni dijelić mene.
Because it's not about me.
Jer ne radi se o meni.
And it has to be like that until the tomb.
I mora biti tako do groba.
Every day, every moment, every instant.
Svaki dan, svaki trenutak, svaki tren.
Has to be about Christ.
Mora biti o Isusu.
And that is to be on the cross.
I to je što znači biti na križu.
It's not about how much I am on the cross.
Ne radi se o tome koliko sam na križu.
It's not about I'm doing better.
Ne radi se o tome da bolje radim.
It's about going all the way.
Znači ići kompletno za cjelokupno.
Just a few months ago I was missioning in Mexico.
Prije nekoliko mjeseci imao sam misiju u Meksiku.
And a woman with her daughter came to me.
I žena sa kćerkom je došla.
And the daughter was gonna go to a convent for an experience.
I kćerka je trebala ići u samostan na iskustvo.
And the mother wanted me to give a word to the daughter before she goes.
I majka žela da reknem koju riječ kćerki prije nego što ide.
So I told the daughter.
Rekao sam kćerki.
The only thing you have to take with you.
Jedinu stvar koju trebaš ponijeti sa sobom.
Is the desire to be 100% holy.
Je želja da budeš 100% sveta.
If you don't have that, don't go.
Ako nemaš to, nemoj ići.
Because it's not about experiencing.
Jer ne radi se o iskustvu.
It's about sanctifying.
Nego o posvećenju.
Otherwise there's no vocation. There's no Christ.
Inače nema zvanja, nema Krista.
Because Christ is not about experimenting anything.
Jer Isus nije, Krist nije u o eksperimentiranju nekakvom.
Christ is about dying to everything.
Krist je o umiranju svemu.
And this world is about process.
Ovaj svijet se radi o procesu.
All modern psychology and all worldly philosophies.
Sve moderne psihologije i filozofije.
They always speak about a process.
Svi pričaju o nekom procesu.
Little by little.
Malo po malo.
Step by step.
Korak po korak.
So they never get anywhere.
I tako nikad ne stignu nigdje.
Because they don't want to get anywhere.
Jer ne žele nigdje dostići.
It's just astuteness.
Astuteness.
It's you know, to be astute like a serpent and humble like a dove.
Aha, to je samo kao kako zmija su
like a smart, smart, yeah. So, but us as Christians,
a mi kao kršćani,
we don't go to a process.
Mi ne idemo kroz proces.
We go to the cross.
Mi idemo na križ.
So we either go to the cross or we don't go.
Ili idemo na križ ili ne idemo.
That's why God says that he despises the lukewarm.
Zato Bog kaže da prezire mlake.
Because the battle that we have,
jer bitku koju imamo,
doesn't allow any mediocrity.
Bitku koju imamo ne dopušta nikakvu polovičnost.
Mediocre soldiers are useless.
Polovični vojnici su beskorisni.
They are weak.
Oni su slabi.
People with doubts.
Ljudi sa sumnjama.
Like the apostle St. James says.
Kao sveti apostol što kaže.
He who doubts is not good.
Onaj koji sumnja nije dobar.
We shouldn't have no doubts.
Mi ne bi trebali imati nikakve sumnje.
No doubts about our faith.
Nikakve sumnje u našoj vjeri.
We either believe or we don't believe.
Mi ili vjerujemo ili ne vjerujemo.
Nothing in the middle.
Nema ništa između.
And that is the nature of our battle.
I to je priroda naše bitke.
Because our enemy,
jer naš protivnik,
believes 100% in evil.
Vjeruje 100% u zlo.
So we are talking about an enemy that is 100% evil.
Pričamo znači o protivniku koji je 100% zao.
So how can you combat it?
Kako ga možeš pobijediti?
Only 100%.
Jedino 100%.
And that can only be done on the cross.
A to se jedino može ostvariti na križu.
So we do have 100%.
Znači mi imamo 100%.
Because Christ gave us what we are lacking.
Jer Isus nam je dao što nam nedostaje.
So we have no excuse.
Nemamo ikakve isprike.
And on top of that, we have been chosen to be his army.
I na, još na to mi smo izabrani da budemo njegova vojska.
We have been set apart.
Mi smo uzeli sa strane.
We have been predestined.
Mi smo predodređeni.
To be the army of God.
Da budemo vojska Gospodnja.
So we were created with all it takes to be a soldier of God.
I stvoreni smo sa svime što je potrebno da budemo vojnici Gospodnji.
But we know that the fuel of our strength,
znamo da gorivo naše snage,
is the love of God,
je ljubav Božja.
So we have to always be in the love of God.
I moramo uvijek biti u ljubavi Božjoj.
When you open your eyes in the morning,
kad otvoriš svoje oči ujutru,
check your love.
Pregledaj svoju ljubav.
Before you get out of bed.
Prije nego što ustaneš iz kreveta.
And if you are not full with love,
i ako nisi pun ljubavi,
don't get out of bed.
Nemoj ustati iz kreveta.
Don't walk one step without love.
Nemoj hodati ni jedan korak bez ljubavi.
Because if you walk empty of love,
jer ako hodaš prazan od ljubavi,
you walk full of Satan.
Hodaš pun Sotone.
Because Satan is going to use you.
Jer Sotona će te koristiti.
Every time Satan sees a vessel empty of love,
svaki puta kad Sotona vidi posudu praznu od ljubavi,
it is an available vessel.
To je posuda koja je dostupna.
And we can never make ourselves available to the devil.
I nikad ne trebamo se ostaviti dostupni za zlo.
Saint Paul tells us that our battle is not with blood and flesh.
Sveti Pavao nam kaže da naša bitka nije sa krvlju i mesom.
That means not among human beings.
Znači nije između ljudi jedni drugih.
It is with powers and principalities of the dark that roam the earth.
Nego sa vrhovnišom i vlastima koji hodaju po zemlji.
So they always ready.
Oni su uvijek spremni.
So that's why when we open our eyes in the morning,
zato kad otvorimo svoje oči ujutru,
we have to make sure we are not an empty vessel.
Moramo biti sigurni da nismo otvorena prazna posuda.
Because sometimes if we don't go to bed at night well prepared,
jer nekad kad ako ne idemo u krevet pripremljeni,
the devil steals the love of our hearts in our sleep.
Satana krade ljubav u našim srcima dok spavamo.
And when we wake up, we're empty.
I kad se probudimo, mi smo prazni.
And if you don't pay attention,
ako ne gledaš,
that becomes very dangerous.
To postaje jako opasno.
Because you keep on walking empty.
Jer hodaš prazan.
And then later on,
i onda poslije,
you find that you are depressed.
Vidiš da si depresivan.
You are confused.
Da si zbunjen.
Doubtful.
Da sumnjaš.
Insecure.
Da si nesiguran.
Angry.
Ljut.
Restless.
Ne mirujući.
And those are signs you have a visitor.
I to su znakovi da imaš posjetitelja.
You have a bad visitor.
Imaš lošega posjetitelja.
So you have to exorcise the visitor.
Moraš egzorcizirati posjetitelja.
Because the longer the visitor in your heart,
jer što je duže posjetitelj u tvome srcu,
the more damage to your heart.
Što više posljedica na tvoje srce.
And this is a battle we wake every day.
I ovo je bitka koju vodimo svaki dan.
And we are an army.
Mi smo vojska.
So we can never sleep.
Tako ne možemo nikada spavati.
Because the devil never sleeps.
Jer Satana nikad ne spava.
So we have to be always alert.
Moramo uvijek biti budni.
And the way to be alert,
i način da budemo budni,
is to make sure we are holy.
Je da vodimo računa o tome da budemo sveti.
There is no other way to fight the good battle.
Nema drugoga načina da se vodi dobra bitka.
Only being holy.
Jedino budući svet.
And this world is gonna get much and much and much darker.
Ovaj svijet će postati puno, puno više taman.
Much darker.
Puno više tamo.
And we have to be aware of that.
Moramo biti svjesni toga.
Because it's going to be even difficult to walk.
Jer bit će teško hodat.
Because of the thickness of the dark.
Od veličine tame.
So much evil in
toliko
the world.
Toliko zla u svijetu.
So much depravation.
Toliko depravation.
Degeneration.
Destrukcije. Destruction.
Degeneracije.
That it makes life very difficult to breathe.
Što čini život jako težak za disat.
So we need to be very strong.
Moramo biti jako jaki.
So that when we go through this world,
tako da kad idemo kroz ovaj svijet,
demons flee.
Demoni bježe.
And yes, you are in cloister.
Da, vi ste u klauzuri.
But you walk through the world.
Ali vi hodite kroz svijet.
Through your prayers.
Kroz vaše molitve.
So your prayers have to have wings.
I vaše molitve moraju imati krila.
They have to leave the convent.
Moraju odlaziti samostana.
And for them to leave the convent,
i da bi one otišle iz samostana,
they have to be strong.
Moraju biti jake.
Otherwise, the birds of the dark will chop your wings.
Inače, ptice tame će izrezati vaše krila.
Will chop your wings of prayer.
Izrezati će krila vaše molitve.
Demons are attentive outside here.
Demoni su spremni okolo ovde.
for every prayer of yours.
Za svaku vašu molitvu.
Because every prayer that comes out of you flies out.
Jer svaka molitva koja dolazi iz vas leti.
And is going towards the kingdom.
I ide prema kraljevstvu.
With a message.
Sa
right?
porukom.
And the demons don't want that message to get there.
A demoni ne žele tu poruku da ode tamo.
So the accuser comes.
I protivnik dođe.
And shows the prayer.
Pokaže molitvu.
To your guardian angel.
Vašemu anđelu čuvaru.
And says that prayer is not good.
I kaže ova molitva nije dobra.
It can't fly.
Ne može letit.
And if he's right.
I ako je u pravu.
The prayer won't fly.
Molitva neće letjeti.
Because it's an economy.
Jer je to ekonomija.
And the angel can only defend us if our economy is strong.
A anđel nas može samo braniti ako je naša ekonomija jaka.
Otherwise the devil wins.
Inače Satana pobjeđuje.
So there's always a battle between the angel, the guardian angel and the demon that is against your prayer.
Uvijek je borba između našeg anđela čuvara i demona što se tiče naše molitve.
Every prayer you have has a demon against.
Svaku molitvu koju imate ima demona protiv nje.
And the demon is watching your heart.
I demon gleda u vaše srce.
And see, are you daring to say that to God?
I govori, jel se ti usuđuješ reći to Bogu?
Show me how good you are.
Pokaži mi kako si dobar.
And this is what matters, right?
I to je ono što je važno.
I'm not saying that it is a sin to send a weak prayer.
Ne kažem da je grijeh poslati lošu molitvu.
It's not a sin.
Nije grijeh.
But it's not a good prayer.
Ali nije dobra molitva.
And do we need weak prayers?
Da li nam treba loša molitva?
We don't.
Ne treba.
We need pure prayers.
Treba nam čista molitva.
But pure prayers have to come from a pure heart.
A čista molitva treba doći iz čistog srca.
So we have to be seriously good prayers.
Moramo biti ozbiljno dobri molitelji.
All of us, every Catholic.
Svi mi, svaki katolik.
No matter who we are.
Neovisno tko smo.
And especially you as Cloister.
Pogotovo vi kao Klauzu.
Because God chose you.
Jer Bog vas je izabrao.
To be a very strong hold of prayer.
Da budete jako snažni držitelji molitve.
So this is an amazing battalion.
Battalion
is an army. And it's a group of soldiers that are set apart for a very special battle. So,
vi ste posebni vojnici koji ste izabrani za posebnu borbu.
And so you have a mission.
Imate misiju.
And the mission is that your prayers are very strong.
A misija je da vam bude molitva jako jaka.
Because you're not supposed to have any distractions from the world.
Jer ne bi trebali imati nikakve distrakcije od svijeta.
So that's the reason you are cloister.
To je razlog zašto ste klauzurni.
Because God doesn't want you to be distracted with anything.
Jer Bog ne želi da budete ometene sa ičim.
So that you could be the support of the war,
da
right?
Da možete biti potpora ratu.
Soldiers that are not attentive to anything else but the prayer, you know, the battle.
Vojnici koji nisu usredotočeni na ništa osim na molitvu i na bitku.
And this is very important to have clear.
I ovo je jako važno da bude jasno.
Because Satan has it clear.
Jer Satana ima to jasno.
He does know who you are.
On zna tko ste vi.
And if you don't really know who you are,
ako vi stvarno ne znate tko ste,
then he is winning.
Onda on pobjeđuje.
Because he will use your unknowing.
Jer on će koristiti vaše neznanje.
Against you and against the church.
Protiv tebe i protiv crkve.
Yes. So you are like a little weapon.
Vi ste kao mala oružje.
But a little weapon is as little as the one that is using it.
A oružje je malo kao onaj koji ga koristi.
So the weapon has been given to you.
Oružje vam je dano.
Your vocation.
Vaše zvanje.
That's the weapon.
To je oružje.
But you are the ones that have to use the weapon.
A vi ste ti koji morate koristiti oružje.
And yet we are vessels of clay.
Mi smo posude glinene.
So we are vulnerable, we are weak, we are sinners.
Mi smo kako?
Slabi.
Mi smo grešnici.
But still, If we keep the vessel of clay clean,
ali ako držimo posudu glinenu čistu,
God will do the rest.
Bog će činiti ostalo.
Because all we need to be is a clean vessel.
Jer jedino što trebamo biti je posuda čista.
Nothing else.
Ništa drugo.
And God does the rest.
Bog čini ostalo.
Remember in Gethsemane?
Sjećate se u Getsemaniju?
Jesus asked the apostles only not to fall asleep.
Isus je tražio od apostola samo da ne zaspu.
He didn't ask them for anything else.
Nije ništa drugo tražio od njih.
Just stay awake.
Samo ostanite budni.
Give me company.
Držite mi kompaniju.
And that's what it is. God wants us to stay awake.
I to je ono što Bog želi, da ostanemo budni.
And to be faithful.
I da budemo vjerni.
And he does the rest with the Father.
I on čini ostalo sa Ocem.
And that's it, you know.
I to je to.
This is the battle.
To je bitka.
The battle is about faithfulness.
Bitka je o vjernosti.
Yeah. And to be clean.
I biti čist.
So we have to work in our heart every day.
Moramo raditi u svome srcu svaki dan.
You know, when you see a kitchen,
kad vidiš kuhinju,
and the kitchen is very clean,
i kuhinja je jako čista,
cockroaches come around,
žauhari dolaze,
and they look,
i gledaju,
and if the kitchen is very clean,
i ako je kuhinja jako čista,
they go away.
Oni odlaze.
But if the kitchen is dirty,
ako je kuhinja prljava,
cockroaches come in and lay eggs.
Oni dolaze i spuštaju svoje jaja.
That's our heart.
To je naše srce.
Like that kitchen.
Kao ta kuhinja.
We have to keep it clean.
Moramo je držati čistom.
So cockroaches of hell don't come in.
Da žohari iz pakla ne dolaze.
Yes, it's very important to have that clear.
I mora, jako je važno da nam to bude jasno.
And also the Holy Spirit is always punctual.
Duh Sveti je uvijek na vrijeme.
So when we belong to God 100%,
kad mi pripadamo Bogu 100%,
and you don't wake up to live with yourself,
i kad se budiš da ne živiš sa sobom,
but to serve God,
nego da služiš Bogu,
Then you are a useful instrument.
Onda si korisno sredstvo.
Because what I was saying, when you open your eyes in the morning, check your love.
Jer ono što sam govorio, kad otvoriš oči ujutru, pogledaj svoju ljubav.
How do you check your love?
Kako provjeravaš svoju ljubav?
You find out how much is about you and how much is about God that moment.
Pogledaš koliko si oko sebe i koliko si oko Boga u tom trenutku.
What is more important?
Što je važnije?
That way you know how much of God is there.
Onda znaš koliko je Boga tu.
And that's how you check your love.
I tako provjeravaš svoju ljubav.
And the Holy Spirit will work with that.
I Duh Sveti će raditi s tim.
He will use you.
On će vas koristiti.
I always tell God in the morning when I open my eyes.
Uvijek kažem Bogu ujutru kad otvorim svoje oči.
Don't let me get out of this bed without your love.
Ne dopusti da izađem iz kreveta bez tvoje ljubavi.
Paralyze me.
Paraliziraj me.
Don't want to give a step without your love.
Ne želim napraviti korak bez tvoje ljubavi.
And this is good to do.
I to je dobro raditi.
Because self-love is very mischievous.
Jer ljubav prema sebi je jako loša.
And very tricky.
I jako zeznuta.
And is justifiable.
I opravdava se.
So we have to be alert.
Moramo biti budni.
Not to let self-love get in our way.
Da ne dopustimo da samo ljublje nam stane na put.
So we should have a prayer that is very strong.
Trebamo imati molitvu koja je jaka.
And it's saying, Lord, it is never about me.
A govori se, gospodine, nije, ne radi se nikad o meni.
It is always about you.
Uvijek je o tebi.
And we should say that all the time.
I mi bi to trebali govoriti cijelo vrijeme.
If you feel troubled, if you feel sad,
ako se osjećaš tužan, ako se osjećaš uznemiren,
if you feel nostalgic,
ako se osjećaš nostalgic,
or lonely,
ili sam,
or offended,
ili uvrijeđen,
you should stop.
Trebaš stat.
And say, Lord, it is always about you.
I reći, gospodine, uvijek je o tebi.
Not about me.
Ne o meni.
What am I doing being lonely?
Šta ja radim osjećajući se sam?
What am I doing being nostalgic?
Šta ja radim osjećajući se kako se kaže, nostalgičan?
What am I doing being offended?
Šta ja radim bivajući uvrijeđen?
What am I doing being angry?
Šta ja radim bivajući ljut?
It is not about me.
Ne radi se o meni.
It is always about you.
Uvijek se radi o tebi.
Please have mercy.
Molim te, smiluj se.
Don't ever let it be about me.
Nemoj nikad dopustiti da bude o meni sve.
And this should be our hymn.
I ovo bi trebao biti naš himan.
It is a way to praise God.
To je način kako se slavi Bog.
And to submit our nature.
I da mu podložimo svoju prirodu.
In obedience to God.
U poslušnosti Bogu.
Because our nature is a rebel.
Jer naša priroda je buntovna.
That's why we have a mortal body.
Zato imamo mortalno, smrtno tijelo.
This mortal body should remind us our nature.
Naše smrtno tijelo bi nas trebalo podsjećati na našu prirodu.
We carry a sentence of death because of disobedience.
Nosimo osudu radi neposlušnosti.
So we have to remember that all the time.
Moramo se toga sjećati uvijek.
We have to submit death to God.
Trebamo prepustiti smrt Bogu.
And never allow death to run your life.
I nikad ne dopustiti da smrt vlada životom.
Because Jesus defeated death on the cross.
Jer Isus je pobjedio smrt na križu.
So we should be alive.
Trebamo biti živi.
And the only way to be alive,
jedini način da budemo živi,
is to be 100% obedient to God.
Da budemo 100% poslušni Bogu.
100%.
100%.
There is no other way.
Nema drugog načina.
Otherwise we are dead.
Inače smo mrtvi.
Because any drop of disobedience,
jel bilo kakav kap neposlušnosti,
is a drop of death.
Je kap smrti.
So we don't want that.
Mi to ne želimo.
It's like they say, how are you? If I'm half dead.
Ko kad te pita kako si, ti kažeš ja sam polumrtav.
We don't want that.
Mi to ne želimo.
We have to say, I am alive.
Moramo reći ja sam živ.
Christ is in me.
Krist je u meni.
He's life.
On je život.
And to end, I'm going to share with you something I always share.
Da završim, nešto ću podijeliti s vama što uvijek dijelim.
Spiritual people,
duhovni ljudi,
understand this.
Razumiju to.
Moses talking to God from the burning bush.
Mojsije priča s Bogom kroz gorući grm.
At the end of the conversation,
na kraju razgovora,
Moses thought,
Mojsije misli,
what happened if they ask me for your name?
Šta će biti ako me pitaju za tvoje ime?
Who sent me?
Ko me poslao?
So he said, my name is Yahweh.
I on je rekao, moje ime je Jahve.
Which means I am.
Što znači ja jesam.
The only one who is.
Jedini koji jest.
And to me that is the greatest revelation.
Za mene to je najveće otkriće.
Because the reason why original sin exists.
Jer razlog zašto originalni grijeh postoji.
Is because the serpent told Eve that if she eats of the fruit, she will be like God.
Jer zmija je rekla Evi, ako jede od toga voća, da će biti kao Bog.
So the devil fooled Eve.
Đavao je prevario Evu.
Because no one can be like God.
Jer nitko ne može biti kao Bog.
He is the only one who is.
On je jedini koji jest.
That's why his name is I am.
Zato je njegovo ime ja jesam.
So if he is I am,
ako je on ja jesam,
I am not.
Ja nisam.
The only way for me to be,
jedini način za mene da budem,
is if God is in me.
Je ako je Bog u meni.
If God is not in me, I am not.
Ako Bog nije u meni, ja nisam.
And this should be very clear to us.
I to treba biti jako jasno nama.
It's the only way to exorcise the devil.
Jedini je to način da se egzorcizira đavao.
How can the devil enter our hearts?
Kako može đavo ući u naša srca?
Every time we think we are.
Svaki puta kad mi mislimo da mi jesmo.
When are you being you?
Kad si ti ti?
When you are offended?
Kad si uvrijeđen?
When you are doubtful?
Kad sumnjaš?
When you are anxious?
Kad si tjeskoban?
When you are afraid?
Kad se bojiš?
Why are you like that?
Zašto si takav?
Because you think you are.
Zato što misliš da ti jesi.
Because if God is the one who is in your heart,
jer ako je Bog onaj koji jest u vašem srcu,
you will never be offended or you will never be afraid.
Nećeš nikad biti uvrijeđen, nećeš nikad strahovat.
Because God is never offended, God is never afraid.
Jer Bog nikad nije uvrijeđen, Bog nikad ne strahuje.
So that's how you know how much are you or how much is He.
I tako znaš koliko si ti, a koliko je on.
In your heart.
U tvome srcu.
So, He is the only one who is.
On je jedini onaj koji jest.
And this has to be very clear.
I ovo mora biti jako jasno.
You know, all world philosophies,
sve svjetske filozofije,
are about me.
Su o meni.
I am.
Ja jesam.
It's like self-realization.
Kako?
Samostvarenje.
Da, samostvarenje.
Mental control.
Mentalna kontrola.
Self-centeredness.
Usredotočenost na sebe.
That's the world.
To je svijet.
And all the philosophies of the world.
I sve filozofije svijeta.
Self-esteem.
Samopouzdanje.
We don't have self-esteem.
Mi nemamo samopouzdanje.
We have Christ esteem.
Mi imamo Krista pouzdanje.
And it's all the opposite.
Sve je suprotno.
So that's why we have to be so awakened.
Zato moramo biti tako budni.
Because it's very subtle.
Jer to je jako... Kako? Subtilno.
And so I pray to God.
Molim Boga.
So that the Holy Spirit,
da Duh Sveti,
enlight each one of you,
prosvijetli svaku od vas,
and make you very, very holy.
I da vas učini jako, jako svetima.
Because this world is filled with demonized people.
Jer ovaj svijet je pun demoniziranih ljudi.
And we are the hope.
Mi smo nada.
We have to be the light.
Moramo biti svjetlo.
True light.
Pravo svjetlo.
You can see how little human beings like Saint Teresa of the Little Flower.
Vidimo kako mala bića kao Sveta Terezija od Djeteta Isusa.
From a little convent like yours.
Kao maloga samostana kao vaš.
They were like sunshine for the world.
Ona je bila kao sunce za svijet.
And all they did was to be faithful, to be holy.
I jedino što je činila je da bude vjerna, da bude sveta.
Nothing else.
Ništa drugo.
So that's our duty.
To je naša dužnost.
So I pray to God that He makes you very holy.
Ja molim Boga da vas učini jako svetima.
This world needs you.
Ovaj svijet vas treba.
Needs your holiness.
Treba vašu svetost.
It's like I say, when you open your eyes,
kao što sam rekao, kad otvoriš svoje oči,
don't get out of bed without your holiness.
Ne ustaje iz kreveta bez svoje svetosti.
Stay in bed if you're not holy.
Ostani u krevetu ako nisi svet.
It's better.
Bolje je.
So I'm going to ask the Lord to give us a word.
Pitaću Gospodina da nam dadne svoju riječ.
And I'm going to read to you from the second letter of Saint Paul to Timothy.
Drugo pismo Svetog Pavla Timoteju.
Chapter 4. I'm going to see how far I read, okay? Preach the word. In the presence of God and Christ Jesus, who is to judge the living and the dead, and by the hope I have of His coming and His kingdom, I urge you to preach the word, in season and out of season, reproving, rebuking, or advising, always with patience and providing instruction. For the time is coming when people will no longer endure sound doctrine, but will be so eager to hear what is new, that they will never have enough teachers after their own liking, and they will abandon the truth to hear fables. So be prudent, do not mind your labor, give yourself to your work as an evangelist, fulfill your ministry.
Zaklinjem te pred Bogom i Kristom Isusom koji će suditi žive i mrtve. Zaklinjem te pojavkom njegovim i kraljevstvom njegovim. Propovjedaj riječ, uporan budi. Bilo to zgodno ili nezgodno. Uvjeravaj, prijeti, zapovjedaj sa svom strpljivošću i poukom. Jer doći će vrijeme kad ljudi neće podnositi zdrava nauka, nego će sebi po vlastitim požudama nagomilavati učitelje kako im godi ušima. Od istine će uho odvraćati, a bajkama se priklanjati. Ti naproti budi trijezan u svemu, zlopati se, djelo izvrši blagovjesničko, služenje svoje posve ispuni. Riječ Gospodnja.
So, I praise God for your community.
Slavim Boga za vašu zajednicu.
For the gift of your vocation.
Za dar vaše zvanja.
And please God that you remain here.
I molimo Boga da ostanete tu.
We need you.
Trebamo vas.
Amen.
Amen.